What other challenges do you see that people struggle in when it comes to remote roles that you have some advice for?
There's a lot of challenges, right? We talked about getting ghosted. We talked about networking. I think the follow-up, a lot of people don't follow up, or when they do follow up, they just go check in on their resume. Mm. Don't ever check in on your resume.
Check in.
It provides no value.
Right.
When you go, and I teach about this in my course and in my programs, I teach a very specific way of finding unique ways to express your value in what we call check-in scenarios, where you are checking in on your resume, but you're not checking in. You're not saying, hey, I'm just checking in on my resume. That's bullshit. It doesn't give them any more of a reason to hire you. You're just creating more work. And this is often a thing I tell my clients to ask themselves. Are you creating more work for somebody, or are you creating less work for them? So if you are constantly creating more work and you're constantly not providing value, you're not going to get hired.
Yes. You're making a statement that if you're constantly not providing value and creating more work for them.
Like, that's what it's going to be like to work with you. Is that you're yes. subconsciously, like, you're right. Not helpful. You're not empathetic. You are just in it for you.
Right. So you're saying that just general awareness. These are empathy, like thinking about how, what is a life of a recruiter, what they're looking for, like putting yourself in their shoes and really thinking about them and trying to solve their problems and just having some self-awareness around, your actions. So that's really good. I have a story, a recent story that I actually made a great connection. My brother-in-law sent me this training gig, a short-term credit training gig for a certification that I was in. And there was a job, posting in LinkedIn. So I actually took your advice based on our previous conversation. And instead of applying to the job, what I did is I actually connected to her on LinkedIn, and I went to her site. She had a podcast, and I checked out some of the content, and I liked some of her posts. And I said, hey, checked out your podcast. I really enjoyed this. You're doing some great work in terms of online content creation. I would love to be in touch. And I also saw that you posted this thing. So I just sent that statement, and that actually worked out great. There were, I think you could see how many people applied for that role. And I was able, she actually booked a meeting with me 3 days after, saying that, hey, I checked out your work too. And that was beautiful. So kind of doing counter, something showing up a little bit differently can
you have to results. Yeah. Every stage of the process, you have to be different. Could be just a little bit different, but you have to be different. That's the key, because if you're not different, you look like everybody else, you're going to get treated like everybody else.
Please like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video. We will sure to come back with more exciting videos on Agile topics.